Okay, so I guess we have to figure out what we're going to do. Just going to throw something together really fast here. Let me see if you have any pictures, any ideas. Okay, it's got to be a planet and a Death Star, a blue one. Yeah, we'll use that one. And maybe some rocks. And a giant ship. And what else? A UFO. And Silicious Crumb. Somehow they're all going to work together. And one of those. Oh, that's the new... That's the new First Order ship. Got to have that. Is there a room for Kylo Ren? Okay. Somehow all these effects are going to... So we're just going to figure out what this is all about. So I guess we have to have a basis for this. So, you know, like a place to put your feet. A place where you can put your boots down. I thought I had some rocks. Where are the rocks
at? The rocks you kind of...
threw over. Okay, we'll put in two rocks. We'll put in those rocks. And these rocks. And any others? Just in case. Throw in a tree. What else? Come on. There's got to be something else. I'll just work what we got. Okay, here we go. Okay. Oh, we have these rocks on the scale. I guess right now the scale doesn't matter. So we just turn these into three, scale them up to 3D objects. That would make more sense. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. We'll turn them into 3D objects. We can have a lot more fun. Because we have the camera. When we add a camera to it, see the camera, and then we're going to be able to do extraordinary things. Extraordinary, I tell you, Kaya.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's move. Let's get two views here. Two views. Well, let's see. What's that one? I want to put that one way back. So far back there. In space, in time. And this one a wee bit. Not too much. Okay. Then we have to scale them right back up. And the same with this mister. We'll scooch him over a little bit. We'll have a platform upon which to maybe perch some of our characters. So we'll get the two of you. We'll have the one view again. Okay. What kind of a scene? It's not a scene unless there's like some kind of a science fiction object. How about the flying saucer? I mean, that says Star Wars, just flying saucer. What says Star Wars more than a flying saucer? Maybe an Imperial Destroyer.
Mm-hmm.
You think better?
I don't know, but flying saucers. I mean, like, the old science fiction, always UFOs.
UFOs. There was an UFO in USA.
In USA.
Oh, we better put this guy way back there in space. Here, let's clear him up. Okay, you're all going. Whoa! There he goes. Goodbye. You're even going behind the big rock. There we go. That's your place. Way up there, but should be further back than that. Maybe I'll scale them up, but this is a very imbalanced presentation, but oh well. Okay, and just for the hex of it. Are there any stars? Are there any stars we got? find some stars. Anything for stars. I have this one called, I don't know why I named it Stars. What's up? Stars. Did I re-change it? Okay. No. We have stars somewhere in the background. So there we go. We have stars in space. Stars in space and Tim. We'll keep that 2D. We'll go room there. Okay. So let's see here. Got Kylo Ren. This is literally a toy. This is one of the toys I have with Kylo Ren. I want him on that. What do you think? He should be right up there on that thing. Mm-hmm. On that promontory.
Mm-hmm.
That's where we're going to put him.
I mean, like, that looks like a good place to stand somewhere, except you kind of can't get a whole lot of places unless you're prepared, unless you come prepared and, like, bring, like, things.
Oh, he's not a 3D object. Okay, there he is. Okay, and I wanted to put him, okay, not on the Death Star, but... Oh, I see what I did. That's the Death Star. He used to be up here. This guy. Yeah. A little wee teeny bit before. Okay. And I can scale him up and down. And then I'll connect him to that place. Okay. You live with. Make sure we know which one is which. Not that one. A3B. So we'll pair you with 83B. That way when we move 83B, you stay on there. I guess his arm's not raised, so we can't add a lightsaber. Oh no. That would take a while. I always want to bring Celestious Crumb back into this universe somehow. Let's do that. Hey, wait a minute. I feel really bad because, you know what? Well, I mean, the thing that started Star Wars was just this love of crazy science fiction. So it's got to be a place for the UFO. An UFO from USA. You agree, right? Tell me you agree, please. Mm-hmm. Okay. I think it should sit right on the side of the Death Star. Let us do that. We're going to set that right on the edge of the Death Star. Okay. No, let's put him on hanging underneath the side of it, because gravity doesn't matter to the UFOs. Okay, now watch what happens. He stays. This parallax perspective. There we go. Is there room for anything else? Are we just gonna crowd this thing out? What do you think, Kaya? Tell me. What do I do? What do I do? Oh.
Just add some trees, maybe Celestious Crumb, and then yeah.
Some trees.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Some trees. Where's a good place to put a tree? You know what? That's just one thing that's always bothered me about the Death Star, is that it was just so void of that kind of life, and you know, you would think that maybe it would bring up morale of the I guess he didn't need that because they had Darth Vader to threaten them if their morale wasn't very good. But a beautiful tree planted on the side of the ship, you know? I mean, that would have gone a long ways to maybe facilitating... Not that, you know, we don't want the Empire to have won in the Return of the Jedi, but surely the Darth Vader allowed the plantation of a beautiful giant tree on the side of the vessel. Then it would have, I mean, you would have had Imperial. I mean, you would have had officers and enlisted in people that would show up and propose to their, because you know they know they're on this ship that's like the target of every rebel outlet in the known galaxy. So their chances, you know, of maybe surviving aren't so good. But they have this one thing, the tree, which represents life itself. And there it is. Let's see if it goes. We got a tree and an UFO. And position, go. It's beautiful. Kaya, you were right. It was beautiful. Oh, we lost the edge of the can. It's beautiful. I think Solicitus Crumb wants to sit right there. Let's go ahead and put... Let's perch Solicitus Crumb up there.
You know what? They need to bring Solicitus Crumb back.
You didn't.
They need to.
I do. I agree with you. I've wondered what happened to me. I think there was maybe some novels or something that said that he lived. He even had a story that took place before he met up with Jabba. I think he like tried, you know, in life he tried very, very hard to make friends. Talk about his early years going to school. He was picked on. His dad was a human ambassador from Coruscant to wherever their planet was at. And so they ended up having to move to Coruscant, and he attended a classroom full of mostly humans. And, I don't know, do you think he should, now by modern standards, the way that we are, he should have been able to fit in just fine. They should have been very accepting of Solicitus Crumb. But no, in that far-flung universe, see, they might have been technologically advanced, but they were not socially advanced. The kids made fun of Solicitus Crumb. That was wrong. So perhaps we should feel bad for him. Say that had things been more fair. Perhaps he would have had a more wouldn't have ended up living with Jabba. Okay. And this is what's really gonna slow it down, but let's see, we'll add something for, because there's nothing over here. It's absolutely no, it's just dead space. So let's add, what do you think? You tell me, what do you think here? Where's the, well, let's go look down at the presets. Rolling smoke, embers. They need embers, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, we need embers there. And scale them up. Embers, where are they? Okay. There's just a few. I need to turn up the number. Let's see. Fun part of it. No scale. A lot more embers for no reason at all. Okay, and some smoke as well. It'll kind of be like subtle behind. And there we are. That's it. It's Kylo Ren having joined forces with Solstice Chrome. Rotate this all over to the side. And an UFO. Let's zoom in on the UFO. Zoom in on the UFO. It's living on the Death Star with the beautiful branches of the tree. We just made the Death Star very pretty. Yes. Okay, call it a wrap.